One of the questions I get most in Sela is, and at VBS we had it this week, is, can God speak to me? And the simple answer is yes. But are we saying yes to it? Are we awakening to it? Are we acknowledging it in our lives? Because he is beckoning us and speaking to us all the time. And I try to explain it to him like, man, maybe it's just that still small voice. And they're like, oh, I wondered what that was. The other day I was doing this and God said, don't do that. I wondered if that was him. Absolutely, that's him. So if you ever struggle, can I have a relationship with the Holy Spirit? Can I speak to him? Can I speak to God? Can I speak to Jesus? The simple answer is yes. If you feel like you're not, what walls do you have up right now? What's keeping you? Do you feel like you have to accomplish XYZ before you know that you're hearing from God? Do you feel like you have a whole long list of things that, well, once I get this together, then I'll be confident in this? When God's just, he's never said that. He's never said, get your stuff together and then join us. He's just saying, are you going to join us? Are you going to get up off the bench? Are you going to join us in this dance of life? Doesn't matter if you have XYZ. Come and join us. We're beckoning you now. Saul, on his way, on the road of Damascus on his way, was a complete and awesome transformation because he was blind and now he sees. And that's what our relationship is with God when we say yes to him. I was blind to the things and now I see and I'm saying yes. So when you hear that still small voice or the booming voice, however God, because he speaks to each one of us differently. And the language he uses is the language that I need. If I go to Jen and I say, God told me this and this, and he said it like this, she might go, wow, God doesn't talk to me that way. No, he talks to you the way you need to hear it. He speaks your language. And so when you have that, you then get the opportunity to say yes to it or to just put one more, I don't know. I don't know if I'm qualified to hear from God. And we just put these walls up. And God's just saying, no, come join me. Come join me in this moment. He's already inside of us. Are we going to say yes to him or not? He's already enthroned upon our heart. Are we going to allow him the space he needs in our life or not? It's really up to us. It's not, I've been praying and begging God to come into my heart. I've been begging him to come into my life, and he's just not doing it. Is that true? Is that the truth? Is that really who God is and what he does? Or is there something keeping me from saying yes to him? Am I worried about how it will look? Am I worried about my performance? Am I worried about not having XYZ together before I say yes? Those are the questions we need to ask. Not, well, I just must not be good enough for God. That's not a factor. That's a lie. I need to find out the truth about the situation.